In this video, I'll demonstrate how to set up the AutoTranscribe Folder Agent in Dragon Medical Practice Edition 2. The AutoTranscribe Folder Agent, or ATFA, automatically transcribes recordings copied to a specific directory. The transcribed recordings are then written to a directory that you choose. The supported file formats for recording device files are WAV, WMA, MP3, as well as unencrypted DSS and DS2. First, open your Dragon profile that has digital audio recorder as the dictation source. Go to Tools from the menu bar and select AutoTranscribe Folder Agent. This will bring up the Dragon AutoTranscribe Folder Agent interface. Our first order of business is to set up a task that associates a user profile with an input and output directory. From the menu bar, click Task and select New. This will bring up the configuration window. Here, you will designate your input and output directories in addition to selecting which Dragon profile will handle the task. You are also given the ability to choose the output file format. The options are .txt, .rtf, or .doc. Let's create a folder structure for our input and output directories. Click the Browse button located to the right of the input directory field. Select a directory by clicking on it. I'm going to put my directories on the desktop. Look at the bottom left side of the File Explorer window and select Make New Folder. I'm going to name the folder something obvious, let's say AutoTranscribe Folder Agent. I press Enter and the folder is created. Now we're going to create a subfolder within the ATFA folder. Select Make New Folder again. I'm going to name this subfolder Input and I'll press Enter. At the bottom right of the File Explorer window, select OK. You've created your input directory. Now let's create the output directory. Click the Browse button located to the right of the output directory field. Click the ATFA folder and select Make New Folder. I'm going to name this subfolder Output and press Enter. At the bottom right of the File Explorer window, select OK. You've now created your output directory. Let's talk about output file format for a moment. The output file format you choose will be dependent upon which program you intend to use for reading, editing, or formatting your transcribed dictation. Which program the file opens with ultimately depends on what file types are associated with that specific program. If you prefer to work in Notepad, choose .txt. .rtf is great if you will be using the document across multiple platforms as it is readable by most word processors. I prefer to work in Microsoft Word, so I'll choose .doc as my output file format. We'll not get into command line options today, so for now press OK. We have successfully created a task. Select Agent from the menu bar near the top left of the ATFA interface. Click Options. Here we will set options for what happens to the audio file after transcription is complete, in addition to whether or not a .dra file is generated. To simply have the audio file deleted after transcription is complete, select Delete it. To have it moved to the output directory after transcription, select Move it to the output directory. It is worth noting that saving the dictation with your documents requires up to 2.5 megabytes of disk space per minute of dictation. Selecting generate.dra file is useful if you intend on opening the transcribed files later for playback and correction. Once settings are to your liking, press OK. Let's see how it all works now. You'll need to exit Dragon in order for the ATFA to work its magic. I have some dictations on my recorder that need to be transcribed, so I'll connect the recorder to my PC and browse to their location. Next, I select the files to be transcribed and drag them to my input folder. You can see that the ATFA begins transcription almost immediately. This is because when the agent is running, it is constantly scanning our input folder for new dictations. Double-click one of the files and it should open in whichever program has that file type associated to it. To see more tech tips like this, subscribe to our Certified eSupport channel. You can check us out on the web at www.certifiedesupport.com.